Now let's consider the power calculations involved in a series RC circuit. In a series RC circuit, there exists a combination of real power and reactive power. The power dissipated as heat by the resistor, or real power, may be calculated as it was in a purely resistive series circuit. Simply multiply the voltage drop across the resistor by the value of the current flowing through it. Reactive power, on the other hand, has no effect on the energy source. It is simply volts times amperes. The reactive power of the capacitor is calculated as it was in a purely capacitive circuit by multiplying the voltage across the capacitor by the capacitive current. The total power using I total and E total in a resistive reactive circuit, such as this one, is called apparent power. Since the apparent power is a combination of real and reactive power, it cannot be designated in either watts or vars. Instead, it is measured in units called volt amperes, abbreviated VA. Previously, we calculated the total power in any circuit by multiplying the applied voltage times the total current. The same is true in a resistive reactive circuit. In our example, the total power equals 100 volts times 2 amperes, or 200 volt amperes. Recall that in a purely resistive circuit, the total real power was the sum of all individual power dissipations in the resistors. Also, in a purely capacitive circuit, the total reactive power was the sum of all individual reactive power determinations. However, because of the differing phase relationships between the voltage and current for each component, the simple sum of the real power and reactive power does not equal the apparent power. The phase relationship of the three power determinations is similar to the voltage phase relationships. Since each power determination is made by multiplying the voltage shown times the current, the power phasor diagram is proportional to the voltage phasor diagram by a factor of the total current. The total apparent power, by the Pythagorean theorem, is equal to the square root of the quantity P sub R, real power, squared, plus P sub C, reactive power, squared. Thus, the total apparent power in our circuit, 200 volt amperes, should be equal to the square root of 120 watts squared plus 160 vars squared.